Kevin, we know that crowdfunding is all the rage with Kickstarter and Indiegogo and other sites that are wonderful. But what if someone does not want to crowdfund? It's not as easy as just posting the campaign. There's a lot of work. It's like a full-time job. Can you talk about other ways of funding, grants, what have you?
Well, I've been lucky to find private money to fund my documentaries, but there are more traditional sources, and that's generally teaming up with either a production company or a network. You know, it's a traditional way. You go and you pitch a network, HBO, what have you, and they're going to go into business with you. That's ideally the way you do things. That's not easy either. So these other avenues have come along. Grants I've never done because you need the patience of Job to do that. That takes forever, and the money's coming in very small amounts. It's possible. I have a good friend doing a documentary now on WC Handy, and she received money, a grant money, and so she's, you know, she's been filming as she goes along. So it is possible. The crowdfunding is also difficult. I've had three friends who have successfully funded at various price points, up from $35,000 up to $200,000. And that's very rare, but it's doable on Kickstarter or Indiegogo. And then there's private individuals. That's another form that I found. That's also difficult, but it does cut through a lot of the back and forth with grants or networks or what have you. So that's always the number one question, and the toughest thing is, how do you get the money to make these things? So, you know, it's really going out to the marketplace and finding out what they're going to say. Well, what's in it for them? Can they make money off this enterprise? Are they going to be able to see the return on their dollar, on their investment? So that's why you consider these things when you're picking your topics. You know, you want to look at the marketplace and say, is there room in the market for this documentary? Has there been competition on this subject? If so, is there room for one more? If not, was there a reason nobody wanted to do this topic? So you're going to look at all of that, you know, as you go into funding. But it's always the most difficult thing. There are new ways to do it. I wouldn't say no to the crowdsourcing, because if you have a good pitch and you have a good idea, and you maybe only need funds to either get started or to finish, maybe $35,000 or $50,000, that's pretty doable. I had some friends who needed finishing funds of $200,000, and they raised $210,000 or so. So it is possible to do if you have an appealing subject.
Let's say, though, you'd like to go the route of pitching a network or an individual that would like to invest in a film. Mm-hmm. What do you need to have in place when you show up? I know something like that, they're going to want to see complete organization. And
right. In my experience, they want to see a written pitch, but they don't want it to be 40 pages. They want it to be between 5 and 10 pages, that they can get the idea of your film that quickly. And nowadays, if you can put any kind of pitch reel together, sizzle reel, kind of trailer. I know you haven't shot it yet, supposedly, but maybe for free on your own dime, you can go down to your subject and get an afternoon with them and get them on tape. And if you shoot it with your HDSLR and you cut it on your cloud editing system, you put it together for very little, and you have their stills which you can license. And so you put together a little 2-minute pitch movie along with a 5-page pitch. You that's all you need. They're going to get it from that. So at least come in with those two things and you have a shot.